because y'all talking about white people are not going to heaven. You talk about white people not going to heaven, and you're allowing everybody to know that white people are the devil, and white people not going to heaven. And that doesn't make any sense because God created them. God created them.
They're going to heaven. You didn't say they're going to heaven. We didn't say that. I never said they ain't going to heaven. White people going to heaven.
Okay, I'm done.
You didn't deny that. They're going to heaven.
You just said the Bible said that white people didn't go to heaven.
They're going to heaven. Of course they're going to heaven.
Okay.
Can I just make another thing? It's about his choices.
Right.
It's choices. Right. That's why God gave free will. It's choices. People make that glance of anger.
To do or don't. Now, he said white people are going to heaven. White folks are going to go to heaven. Yeah. Of course they're going to go. All nations are going to go to heaven. Just not the way I think they're going to go.
But if you're praising them, that's if you. But if you're praising God and working in the word.
Let me explain to you how they're going to go to heaven. Can I explain to you how they're going to go to heaven? Isaiah 14, verse 1.
Isaiah 14 and 1.
You see, throughout history, there's always been a higher class and a lower class, a ruling class and a serving class. Throughout the ages, from Babylon to Medo-Persian Empire to Greece to Rome, until now, America is a superpower. America tells other lands what to do, right? Is this a lie? Am I lying to y'all? It's fact. Ruling class, superpower, serving class, third world. You understand? That's how it is. So let's see how it's going to be in the kingdom of God, if that's going to change.
Isaiah 14 and 1, for the Lord.
Hold on. Sister Miss, listen, how we get over here? How we brought here? You came
by
here by
ships.
What kind of ships? Cruise? Nah. What, Disney cruises?
Slave ships.
Who brought us those ships, may I ask?
It's Caucasian.
Oh, very good.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel.
Will yet choose Israel, because Israel's rebellious, but he'll still choose them anyway. Go ahead.
And set them in their own land.
And will set us who are Israelites in our own land when we get delivered out of this hellhole called America. Because we're in hell now. I think in hell you die and it burns. Oh, it burns.
That's
hell? No, not even. You're right. So to a degree, yes.
Because it's a spiritual realm.
Right. Hell is the condition right now we're in today. Ghettos and slums, last time first fight, abortion clinics, single mothers, single fatherhood, low income, low education, low self-esteem. These are hell. Hell is conditions. With food stamps, Section 8, that is called hell today. We've grown accustomed to hell. We go into the heaven. It has to burn. It has to be destroyed.
We
don't. So when it does be destroyed, let's see what happens. You got all quick. Let me get real quick. Go ahead.
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
Other nations, white, Arab, African, go ahead.
And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place.
Us, take them to their place, go ahead.
And the house of Israel shall possess them.
What shall we do to the nations?
Shall possess them.
If I possess you, what are you to me?
Property.
Huh?
Property,
which means makes you a what? Makes you a what? What did I make you? If I possess you, what are you to me? If I possess you? Oh, go ahead.
Yeah.
Shall possess them in the place of the Lord for servants and handmen.
See, the kingdom of heaven, they're going to get the kingdom. But they're going to be in a low class. They're going to be where we are now. We're going to be where they are now. We'll be ruling and they'll be serving. Like I'm supposed to be.
That's right.
You understand that?
It's great to us since I inherited.
Right, exactly. It's a good tour. Exactly. All right?
Give me
a tour. You're going to turn to a fire. You got a flyer?
Are you saying all white people are going to heaven? So you're saying all white people are going to heaven, all people of all nations are going to heaven. But us white people are going to be held at a lower class?
Let me ask you a question. Where are your people right now in this world? Are they on the lower or are they in the upper? Where are they?
Not me.
Well, not you, that's true, but that's your essential to the rule. See, like for example, us right now, we're where you're at right now. But your people are ruling, so that's pretty much, that's on you. You got to take advantage. You understand? You gotta take advantage of that. Right now, your people are ruling right now. So you have more. Even in your condition right now, you're better off than I am, because you have the complexion for the protection. They're not shooting you. The cops ain't killing you. They're not shooting at you or awfully arresting you. They're doing it to us. So right. Even in your poor condition, you're still better than us right now in the society. Right. They'll hire you before they hire me. Right. You understand? That's your, this is your world. This is your world. So even in your low condition, you can still be my boss. You can be my manager. Right. So at the end of the day, you gotta work it out. It's your kingdom. Work it out. Okay. Work it out. Brother better work it out. Now, you know that?
I just got one statement.
Yeah, 22. Oh, she's
going now.
Well, say it. Okay. Like, I commonly hear that you guys say my ancestors had brought you guys, black people, here for slavery.
Yep.
But my ancestors had nothing to do. My ancestors were born and raised in Ireland.
Right.
They had nothing to do with slavery. They had Irish slaves.
Let me ask you a question. The black folks that have last names like McDonald or McGrady, who are their slave masters? The Irish last names.
They did that for stage names.
Let me ask you again. The black people I know that's true. You had the immigration laws, y'all came over here. Y'all had, immigrants came over here. That's what they call it. They gave y'all land. They gave y'all land and $1,000. Y'all were indentured servants. When they brought us over here, they extended that law later on. And then y'all took the liberty, the land, and took us and worked us on your land. When you do the research, Irish came over here as indentured servants. They worked a certain amount of time, then they got the land, and $1,000 is a lot of money at the time. $1,000 back then was a lot of money. They gave Irish land, and they gave y'all $1,000. And guess who had worked on that land after you got it? Us worked on that land when you got it. So, y'all were brought here, y'all were the lower class whites, like the movie, Gangs of New York. Ellis Island, that's it called. Ellis Island. They brought the immigrants over here. Y'all came over for opportunity and liberty, and you got it. You still have your land. You still have your culture. You still have your language, whatever the case may be, but we don't. You can go back to your land and be all right. See, we can't do that. See, our land is destroyed by a bunch of so-called Jews on the other side of the world, and then you're willing on this side of the world. You conquered us on this side of the world as the Christians. You took our nationality as Jews over there, then conquered us over here as Christians, which are still Jews, on this side of the world. So at the end of the day, regardless of your ancestry, you are still in relation to the people that had us enslaved.
Right.
And therefore, the Most High says you reap what you sow.
Right.
Now, right now, this is your world. This is your time to have your fun, to get your glory. This is your kingdom. You govern all. Your people run this thing. Now, you can get out of it, like I said before. You being who you are, me being who I am, your chance is a lot better than mine. I've done research where they say a white person with a police record has a higher chance than a black person with a degree without one. This is your world. So have your fun in your world. Drink to your heart's content. Do what you must. But I'm out here for them on this side right here, according to the Bible. For the Israelites, you understand? So at the end of the day, Isaiah 14 says that we're going to be the ruling class in the kingdom, and you guys will be the lower class, as right now you guys are ruling. It's your world. So when Christ returns, he's going to bring back things to the way they're supposed to be, with us on the top and everyone else, not just whites, but everyone else on the bottom, where they originally were before. Leviticus 25, verse 44.
Yeah, in your case, too bad.
Right.
You understand? In your case, it's too bad. You understand? Then in your case, it's a shame. To be a white man, don't have nothing. It's a shame. In your case.
But
in your case. You understand? This is your world. So you're supposed to have something,
but
guess what? No, we serve because of our sin. You understand? Now that's our time to repent back to the Father. Then he can give us our rulership back. All nations supposed to come in shackles and chains when we rule in power. Same way we came butt naked with chains and shackles, you're going to come in the kingdom the same way. You understand? This ain't going to be no favoritism. Same way we come on your course, it's the same way you're going to come in our course. You understand? So get ready, man. In your case, I'm sorry. It's too bad for you.
Right.
You understand? Because as a result, this right here is a result of you. It's a result of you. This is a result of your people as well. And not forget the Hispanics, Native Americans, North, South, Central America. This is all y'all right here. So I gotta pay for this. Right now it's your time to have fun. Live your life, sip your coke, whatever it is you do. It's your world, have fun, live it, love it, enjoy it until Christ returns. Now, give me
the color of my skin 25. Nothing to do with this.
It doesn't. It's not about color of your skin. You have people in our congregation who may be lighter than you, but it's about nationality. You understand? So if you are, if you're, which is not Israelite, not Israel. But if you are Israel, you may get in North as well. If you're not, I feel sorry for you if you're not Israel.
That's right.
25:44.
Leviticus 25:44. Boom! Thy bondmen and thy bondmaids, which shall be of the heathen that are round about you.
So the law was that the nations who are outside of our own would be our bondmaids and bondmen. Slave men and slave women. That was their purpose. These nations out here today, there are slaves on the loose. It's like a wild dog running around doing what he wants to do, looking at his own balls. That's what dogs do. And the white man today, and the Arab man, the African man, that's them. They're like rabid dogs running around without a leash.
Right.
Destroying things, killing, destroying lives, taking confrontations, stealing identities. That's what they do. They're wild. They must be tamed.
And
when
the
pressure turns, they will be tamed.
That's right.
Of them shall ye be, of them shall ye buy bondmen and bondmaids.
So all nations outside of the nation of Israel, their purpose is to serve us while we serve our God. They serve us and keep the laws that our God gives us. That's the role of their purpose, to be slaves. They conquered the Native Americans on this side of the world, North, South, Central America. They conquered us and brought us over here from West Africa and other parts of Africa and brought us over here to work slave labor. So they must reap what they sow. It's what it is. It's called cause and effect. Some of y'all call it karma. We call it God.
That's right.
So it is. Read on.
Moreover, of the children of the strangers that do sojourn among you, of them shall ye buy.
Of them shall we what?
Of them shall ye buy. And of their families that are with you.
And their kids too. Go ahead.
Which they beget in your land.
Which they beget in our land. Go ahead.
And they shall be your possession.
They shall be our what? What's the white man, the Arab man, the African man, the Chinese man, the Asian man, whatever man be?
And they shall be your possession.
If you're my possession, that means I own you. That means you do what I say. You're under my subjection. You understand? Read on.
And ye shall take them as an inheritance for your children after you.
So not only do we get them as our slaves, but our children inherit their kids as slaves. This generation is ongoing. That's how it's supposed to be. Go ahead.
To inherit them for a possession, they shall be your bondmen forever.
How long?
Forever!
How long?
Forever!
So the purpose of every nation on this earth outside this sign is to be a bondmaid and man forever.
What?
Slave
what?
Forever. Y'all can't see that. Y'all see Brad Pitt, y'all see Hulk, you see Spider-Man throwing web around. That's what y'all see walking around here. I see slaves on the loose. That's what I see. I see Thor, you see Jesus, you see the angels, you see Daredevil, you see Batman, you see Tom Cruise, that's your guy. That's who y'all see. But we see slaves. We see monsters. We see devils. That's what the Bible says. That's what God sees. All right? So, now, give me the book of Jeremiah 30, verse 16. Jeremiah 30 and 16. I don't think we got to that. We'll get to it and pass it up. Jeremiah 30, verse 16. Got that? Just in case there's any doubts that you read what you sow is not in the Bible.
Jeremiah 30, verse 16. Therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured. And all thine adversaries, every one of them.
All our adversaries, the Arabs, Africans, white, Samoan, Italian, whatever you want to call them, Chinese, Japanese, all our adversaries, every nation on the earth outside of our own, had a hand in the destruction of the so-called black and Latin American people. The so-called black and brown people, all nations had their hand and continue to have their hand today in the plight and destruction of our people. Whether it be psychological, spiritual, religious, economic, they have a plot. They all are involved in our people's destruction in some way or another. At some point in time or another. Read on.
In every one of them.
So the Bible says every last one of them. The ones you refer to as good ones or bad ones, whatever you want to call them, go ahead.
Every one of them shall go into captivity.
Go where?
Go into captivity.
Understand that? They shall go into captivity.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.